नमस्कार। एस्थमा इज अ मेजर नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज विच अफेक्ट्स अडल्ट्स एज वेल एज चिल्ड्रन बोथ। अकॉर्डिंग टू स्टेटिस्टिक्स एस्थमा हैज अफेक्टेड अराउंड 262 मिलियन पीपल इन 2019। इट हैज कॉज्ड इवन 461,000 डेथ्स। बट इन टुडेज टाइम पीपल टेक एस्थमा वेरी लाइटली। They think it is like a common cold. But it is serious and can be fatal if asthmatics don't take care on time. Asthma is a complex condition. Every individual responds to a unique set of factors. In one individual, many factors can be responsible. Generally, inflammation and narrowing of airways can cause varieties of symptoms in people. Coughing, wheezing, shortness of breath, chest tightness, and so on. All of these factors can have a very bad impact on person's day-to-day activities. So, it is critical to take preventive measures and stay healthy and avoid asthma attacks or all these other symptoms. People who have asthma usually feel uneasy in the morning because congestion worsens at night due to colder temperature. So today, I am going to provide certain necessary morning routine which would help person to prevent all such problems which they usually suffer in the morning. First, the moment you wake up, begin with your bed stretches. Do some stretching, do some asanas, take few long breaths, massage your forehead, bring warmth into your morning. Because asthma, cold, cough means deficiency of warmth and heat. And so, bring warmth and heat in your body. At sunrise, this is a time of temperature fluctuation. And so, this is a very sensitive period for asthmatics. Some stretches like Pavan Muktasan, Yastikasan, Pavan Muktasan's different variations and Bhadrasan could be very easy to perform. This would activate your body and remove stiffness from your body so that you will be able to carry your morning routines easily. Second, facial massage for sinuses. After these simple stretches, sit in your bed and do Kapalrandra Dhoti, Karnarandra Dhoti will help you stimulate facial nerves and help to remove congestion from these areas. This would help improve your blood circulation and make you feel easy throughout the day. The congestion would be gone right in the morning and you will feel very comfortable. Using both the hands or one hand and massage your facial muscles. Make sure you use your fingertips and keep a deep or moderate pressure and see that the congestion is taken care of. During massage, use your thumb, press it at the end of the eyebrows. Rub your fingers on the forehead horizontally from right to left. Now take your index finger or middle finger and keep it at the bridge of your nose. It should be near the eyes at the starting point and move them down under the eyes outwards towards the temple. Rub your index finger from the front of the ear towards back couple of times. Third point, cleanse the tongue to remove the cough. After facial massage, brush your teeth, use tongue cleaner and clean your tongue, and then do Jivha Mool Shodhan. Jivha Mool Shodhan is a technique which aids in cleaning the mouth and remove the excess mucus from the throat. Once you cough out, chest feels lighter and breathing becomes much better throughout the day. Insert your finger deep down. It could be first and two or central two fingers. Take it in as deep as possible near that uvula, the small tongue which is hanging. Move that, bring your finger in that region and then you would feel like puking, puke out and the cough mucus would be removed. After all this, gargle with water. Fourth point, drinking warm water is a must. Drink a glass of lukewarm water after brushing and tongue cleaning. warm water really helps removing the mucus out. It loosens up the mucus and it throws it out to see that we breathe much better, much easier way. After drinking a glass of warm water, focus on your abdomen, walk little bit and see that you evacuate your bowels properly. And then take a glass of warm water, squeeze half a lemon and put little pinch of haldi, put honey and drink this liquid in the morning. This would help you to relax your airways and open up your bronchial tubes. Fifth point, another kriya for facial sinuses. After all these drinks, do Kapalbhati. It removes excess phlegm in sinuses and nasal passages. It removes all the toxins from the respiratory passage. It reduces the frequency of sinusitis and it helps removing the symptoms of asthma, that is cold and cough. To do Kapalbhati, sit in Sukhasana. Inhale and exhale sharply, forcefully and quickly without contorting your facial muscles. Here, the muscles of the throat would automatically be used. Avoid flaring the nostrils and ensure that there are minimum movements in the body. The friction of a sharp breath is going to create a moderate sound. Remember that these are the sharp breaths, equal inhalation and exhalation, and do it for some time. Do at least 30 rounds and then take a long inhalation, hold for some time and relax. After Kapalbhati, do pranayama. This pranayama is called as Bhramari pranayama or honey bee breath. This helps to release congestion in head and facial region. The buzzing sound resonates in the head and in turn the resonance radiates and reverberates in the whole body. This helps alleviating the mild cold symptom and helps person to breathe properly. So here, sit comfortably in any meditative posture and keep your mouth totally closed. Now inhale and while exhaling, make a sound of honeybee slowly and continuously. The sound need not be very loud, but it should create vibrations. And repeat this 4 to 5 times. Another point is sun gazing. After pranayama, go to the balcony or go to your garden and face the sun. Take the sun rays on your face. This is called sun gazing. This would help you to increase warmth in your body and see to it that the mucus and cough production is reduced or removed. For sun gazing, stand straight or sit and look at the sun when it is rising, that orange-red ball. Completely when it rises, then close your eyes and take the sun rays on your face. You should look at sun only when it is rising or setting, not otherwise. Continue gazing till your eyes get watery and then gently close your eyes and cup your eyes with palm. Do palming. Eighth point, excellent asana for airways. Once you are done with sun gazing, do your regular practices with asanas. Practice head low posture like Sarvangasana or Ardha Sarvangasana, which would help in drainage of collected secretion. Forward bending asanas like Hastapadasana, Yoga Mudra, Chakrasana, Konasana 3, etc. So all these asanas are excellent to help circulation to your lungs. Also, asanas like Konasana 1 and 2 help underused muscles which are holding your lungs from the side to help breathe much better and improve the vital capacity of your lung. Ninth point, ensure to eat only warm breakfast. After a good asana session, see to it that you eat a healthy, warm breakfast. Asthma patient should have warm drink and food because cold food can aggravate their condition, causing more mucus and cough and congestion in their body. whereas warm food and liquid helps to release cough and mucus from your body. If you have a congestion, use hot water bag, keep it on your face, on your throat, and help your body to release congestion. So follow these techniques and stay away from all those things which can trigger your asthma. Some people have sensitivity towards dust, so always cover your face and then be in dusty area. Some are sensitive towards certain food, keep away from that food till you overcome your asthma. So see to it that you understand what are the triggering factors and avoid them till you become totally healthy. Remember to maintain a healthy weight. Overweight always creates problem, so see to it that your weight is in control. Now, here is a place of mind. Human mind can create a hell. When mind gets disturbed, when anger is vented, emotions are bottled up, mucus generation is much, much more, attacks can come very easily. So try and see that you look at life joyfully, positively. All the shortcomings around are enjoyed and don't get angry. Take charge of yourself. Learn to be happy in any situations in life. Don't bottle up the emotions. Dance, jump, be physically active and you'll be much healthier and better. Fine. Look after yourself and namaskar.